This life is so crazy. It is terrific and troublesome. But there is always a hope to overcome. Life may turn upside down without any clue like mine. I'm an old blind beggar who appears at the market gate with the help of my old wife. Every day, she leads me up there in the morning, makes me sit, and comes up again at midday with some food, gathers all my coins, and takes me home back at night. One day, as I appeared at the market gate, Tiger was sleeping nearby. Tiger, he's not so impressive, but one of those commonplace dogs whose color is of white and dust. He was born on the streets and feeds on leftovers and garbage. He had spotty eyes and needless pugnacity that earned him scars of 100 fights on his body. Of course, my wife described his appearance out of my curiosity, as I'm a blind man who can see things only through senses, you see. So, Tyler was sleeping nearby. He was stirred by the smell of food, which my wife got it for me. He came out of his shelter and stood before me. I could sense his tail wagging and his head gazing at my ball. He made sounds, expecting some food from me. I threw a handful of food, at which the dog ate gratefully. Perhaps it was an auspicious moment for making friendship. From that day, my meal has always an extra share for him too. Every day, we meet at the same place. He sits beside me and watches me receive alms from morning to evening. He also makes sure that I receive a coin from every passerby. Whoever went without it dropping a coin will be chased by him. He tucks the edge of their claws and pulls them back towards me and let them go only after something is dropped in my bowl. That's how the bond between me and Tiger grew. But like I said, life has upsides and downsides. My lady didn't return to the market that day. I was waiting as the sun went down. My neighbor, the ribbon vendor, appeared and said, "Sami, please do not wait. Your wife is not going to return. She died this afternoon." The one and only woman who takes care of me, and the one whom I am living for, has gone forever, leaving me all alone and making my darkness even darker. The ribbon mender tied a ribbon around Tiger's neck. and suggested that to take care of the dog and to take help of him to reach home. From that day, Tiger was my every hope to live. He takes me to the market every day and helps me in begging alms, shares the food we get and brings me home back at night. But one day, our routine was not regular. The little rascal appeared at the market gate. He's a village urchin, who's also a mischievous little rascal. He tries to tease this blind fellow by calling different names, but tries to scratch my ball. It's my ball. Give it back to me, you little rascal. Help. I used to shout and cry helplessly. But this time, that rascal took scissors and cut the ribbon which separated Tiger from me. Tiger! Tiger! Where are you? Tiger! Come back! Tiger! Tiger, out of excitement, ran away. Maybe he's missing his friends and freedom, which I didn't realize. That little rascal was lost in his locker, watching me half dead in the middle of the market. I struggled a lot to cross the roads while vehicles dodged me. I slipped and fell down as I walked on uneven surfaces. I stood up and reached home after hours. I always wonder, when would be my turn for peace? who's that? Who's that? Tiger? Tiger? You came back to me? My boy? Tiger? No, stop. Stop again. Tiger? Tiger? Come now. You missed this blind fellow? Tiger? Are you hungry, Tiger? Do you want to give me something? Wait. I'll get you something. Just then, when I had lost all hopes, Tiger came back to me. Just because of gratitude that I fed him a little amount of bread. Maybe this is faithfulness. Now, all I have is Tiger. He is my everything. A ray of hope in my dry and lonely life. Stop, Tiger. Tiger, you always play with this bloody man. Tiger, stop, Tiger.